Never, ever, ever accept anything less than what you deserve. But on the other hand, make sure you accept the situation as it is, because there is something bigger than you. I promise you, there's something bigger than you that is beyond you, something beyond your comprehension, and just accept the situation. So what do? Do you not accept less than what I know I deserve, or do I accept the situation? But wait, I'm not done yet. Also, don't accept any kind of behavior from any person, because not everyone is for you. Not everyone in your corner is cheering for you. But if someone does you wrong, accept their apology, forgive them, and let bygones be bygones. And really, we can go in a million different directions of acceptance and explore that, and we will over time. But for today, we're going to keep it simple and talk about the two things. The one being the acceptance from a standpoint of where you are in life, and the other one is how people interact with you. So, number one, where you are in life, accept the situation where you are. Yes, I said it, accept where you are. So let's create an example here. You're making $50,000 a year, and you know that the life that you want, the house you want, the car you want, because that's what fits for your family, not because you just want to have material things, because those are the things you know that will create the environment that you have discussed with you and your partner and your family. You know $50,000 a year is not going to get you there. So what I'm saying is, accept that right now, the money you are making today, right now, will not get you what you want. However, you can take those steps to get to where you want to be. So the accepting the now is not to focus on, oh my gosh, the $50,000, I can't get that car that has, you know, that's safer for my children. We don't have that house to have the library where the kids can study. You know, that is the now. Accept the now, be grateful for what you have right now, and take those steps towards what you want or where you want to go. And last but certainly not least, because this is a hard one for me, is to accept people for who they are and where they are, especially when they have hurt you, when they have hurt you emotionally, when they have disappointed you, when they have betrayed your trust. That's a hard one. But I tell you what, the best thing you can do is accept the situation. That doesn't mean accept that person, that you allow that person to be in your life, to remain in your life as an active major character. Not at all. That means accept the situation. Don't carry that anger, that frustration, that disappointment with you, because as long as we hold it in here, we do damage to ourselves. And not only do we do damage to ourselves, because we don't feel good about that, is we create a barrier oftentimes that we don't even recognize for other people. There are good people who want to enter your life, who need to enter your life. But as long as you carry this frustration, this anger for someone else who has done you wrong, you are blocking it from somebody else to come into your life. And that is what we do not want to have happen. So accept the situation. Say, okay, wow, you know what? I didn't expect that from you. You hurt me a lot. You embarrassed me. You've insulted me, so forth and so on. And you know what? Thank you for showing me the real you, and let it go. Now, it's easier said than done, because we can talk about that in a very safe container, but practice that. Practice the acceptance. Anything that you're holding on to with people, it could be family, it could be your current partner, it could be an ex-partner, it could be a coworker. Accept the situation, walk away, understand and know that there is something bigger for you, but as long as you're focused on this one situation from one person, from one thing, even though this person is important to you, you block anything else that could potentially come into you. And that's where we're gonna leave it for acceptance. Again, we're not gonna accept the situation to stay where we are. We're not going to accept the situation to allow someone to remain in our lives. We accept the situation for what it is, to remain grateful for what it is that we have, and to focus on what it is that we want and the people that we want into our lives. So today, who are you going to accept? What are you going to accept to make sure that you let everything else that needs to come into your life comes flooding in?